Good day to all, especially to my professor, Mrs. Maybelline Kabotahe. First, I would like to thank for this opportunity to share my topic. My name is Junin Bernardino, graduated from Baisla University of Science and Technology with a degree of Bachelor's of Science in Management, major in Entrepreneurship. I am currently employed in Middle East Battery Company as battery technician here in Dammam, Saudi Arabia. My first responsibility is to operate the machine which is used in the manufacturing process. Another one is to check and ensure the product quality of the product in order to achieve customer expectations. Another one is to perform good housekeeping and coordinate with the warehouse personnel regarding the materials used in the production. Actually, my topic is not related to my current job, but it is also related to my previous job. It is all about conflict and negotiation. Okay, what is conflict? Conflict refers to some form of friction, disagreement, or discord arising within a group when the beliefs or actions of one or more members of the group are either resisted by unacceptable to one or more members of another group. The types of conflicts are conflict with persons, the number one. This is the common type of conflict that happens to a person against another person. Number two, relationship. Among the types of conflict, the ones dealing with relationship are the hardest and most delicate. This is because this kind deals mostly with emotions, and emotions can cloud even the best minds. Number three is values. This is the one of the prettiest types of conflict, considering that values come in different shades and colors, depending where you came from. Every religion and every culture have their own set of values that can clash. Another one is interest. Conflict of interest are some of the more common types experienced by many of us interacting with all the other people. The issue are many: money, time, resources, including procedural and psychological issues like trust, respect, honesty, fairness, etc. Conflict of interest have two definitions. Number one is a situation that has the potential to undermine the impartiality of a person because of the responsibility of a clash between the person's self-interest and professional interest or public interest. Number two is a situation in which a party's responsibility to a second party limits its ability to discharge its responsibility to a third party. The reason why conflict involved in negotiation, and this is because of the personal and company interest. I must say the two kinds of conflict when it comes to interest, because there are different shades among the two. Personal interest, this is the valuable things to be returned after negotiation like commission, gifts, etc. While company interest is to comply the goal and objectives, especially the rules of the company, what is the benefits of the company before, during, and after the negotiation. With all the information given above, I just want to share my personal experience in my previous job. But before I will share it, I hope that the story should only for the group to take another information, including the topics like conflict, emotions, mood, motivation concept, decision making, and leadership as well. Okay, this is the story. I worked in manufacturing company for almost 8 years. In early years of my employment, I was production team leader. I have not found yet any problem during my term in production. But almost 4 years ago, I was transferred in other area as integrated warehouse administrator. One of my responsibilities is handling of hazardous waste and toxic waste materials, also the solid waste materials, such as scrap for sale, residual waste that for final disposal, hazardous toxic waste for sale and for treatment. So meaning there is a sales involved. When I started as administrator, the total revenue for scrap sale all over the plant is only 600,000 pesos in 1 year. But due to some techniques that I made, including the ideas of my colleagues, the sales was increased up to 1.8 million. In the succeeding years, one of the helpful techniques is the proper segregation of scrap so that we can sort each garbage carefully daily. Of course, I am in charge too to find a buyer to buy all the saleable scrap, including hazardous and other common scrap like carton, metal, styro, etc. I am negotiating the scrap buyer to hold the scrap, and sometimes I can take over the sales when the accounting office was closed or the cashier was absent or on duty in the other office. Take note, there is no cashier directly hired in the plant. The cashier was duty randomly at from time to time. So they gave me an authorization to take over the sales, and I will remit it when the cashier is available. There is no problem in my daily routine because the scrap buyer is only one. But in the next bidding, the scrap buyer winner will be two. One in charge for hauling of carton and plastics, and another one is the rest of the scrap. So meaning the competitiveness between the two buyers will be more during hauling activities. But hiding in my knowledge, the copy of our bidding for both respective buyers was left in my table, and one of my colleagues showed it to both scrap buyers, and the competition of bidding was so pressured on the next bidding, and because of that, my colleagues was accepting tips every transaction to both scrap buyer, and because most of the time I'm very busy, I asked my colleague to take the payment and to give it to me after that of every activities. But one day, my manager decided to transfer all the waste to another building, not the jurisdictions of my area. It is really favor for me because my responsibility must be less, but my colleagues won't to transfer, and he can do everything to prevent the transferring. But since it's a manager decision, we will never change it. After a few days, one of the scrap buyer member tell me the truth, the reason why my colleagues want to transfer because of the tips given by scrap buyer. And after that, my colleagues will always doing his job taken for granted. His emotions and mood will be changed, and also his motivation was down unlike before. That is what we call conflict of interest. With respect to my colleague's part, it's all about conflict of interest, and in my part, it's all about negotiation. In management decision, maybe if I am the manager, I will give a disciplinary action because accepting money or any kind of valuable things is strictly prohibited as per company policy. Unless nobody knows about his tactics, I'm just doing it for only consideration as a manager, and I talk to him to prevent it again. Okay, we are going now to negotiation. Let's talk about what does it mean. Negotiation. This is a dialogue between two or more people or parties intended to reach an understanding, resolve point of difference, or gain advantage in outcome of dialogue to produce an agreement upon courses of action to bargain for individual. Negotiations occurs in business, non-profit organizations, and government branches, legal proceedings among nations, and in personal situations such as marriage, divorce, parenting, and everyday life. In negotiation, there are also strategies. Negotiation can take a wide variety of forms. from the negotiator acting on behalf of particular organization or position in a formal setting. The first strategy is distributed negotiation. Distributed negotiation is also sometimes called positional or hard bargaining negotiation. It tends to approach negotiation on the model of haggling in a market. The term distributed implies that there is a finite amount of the thing being distributed or divided among the people involved. Example would be buying a car or a house or something. Number two is integrative negotiation. Integrative negotiation is also sometimes called interest-based or principled negotiation. It is a set of techniques that attempt to improve quality and likelihood of negotiated agreement by providing an alternative to traditional distributive negotiation techniques. While distributive negotiation assumes there is a fixed amount of value to be divided between the parties. Integrative negotiation often attempts to create value in the course of the negotiation as well as the interest of the parties. The word integrative implies some cooperation. Integrative negotiation often involves a higher degree of trust and the forming of a relationship. There are many different ways to categorize the essential elements of negotiation, such as process, behavior, and substance. In process, refers to how the parties negotiate. Example, in buying of house or car, the process is how to convince the customer to buy the car or a house. Next is behavior, refers to the relationships among these parties, the communication between them and the styles they adopt. Number three is substance, refers to what the parties negotiate over the agenda and the issues, the option and the agreements reached at the end. Another view of negotiation comprises four elements. Number one is strategy, two process, three tools, and number three is tactics. Strategy comprises the top level goals, typically including relationship and the final outcome. Process and tools include the steps that will be followed and the roles taken in both preparing for and negotiating with the other parties. The last is tactics. Include more detailed statements and action and responses to another statement and action. Negotiation tactics. Tactics are always an important part of the negotiating process. Tactics are more frequently used in distributed negotiation and when the focus is on taking as much value of the table as possible. Many negotiation tactics exist. Below are a few commonly used tactics. Number one, professionalism. In professionalism, using professionalism is the key factor of motivation during negotiations to become more effective and surely the one party that can negotiate it, like wearing of good dress to become seriously trustworthy and to become effective as well. Number two, word of honor. The one party is looking for the word of honor per se. If there is a word of honor, it includes also the integrity, discipline, and trust. Number three is promotion. Negotiators need to develop their ideas to be more effective during negotiation. Example, during negotiation, you need to give any promotion or discount. Number four, honesty. This is the major factor of motivation during negotiations. And by giving of honesty in negotiations, factors could be considered and these are quality, cost, delivery, assurance and benefits as well. Number five is sample. It is good to provide sample during negotiations to carefully show what the product to be negotiated. This can be found when the product to be negotiated is tangible, but in other forms of negotiation, the negotiators will use a quotation as reference.